हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल नाउ? हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
यस सर।
आई वॉज लॉग्ड आउट फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट, जस्ट कनेक्टेड बैक। ओके, the next concept or the next type of cyber crime is webjacking. Let us do one thing now. I will explain this what webjacking is. Before that, I just want to hear from you. So what would be the meaning of webjacking? You might have heard a kind of a different type of jacking, like hijacking. You might have heard in the movies or in the newspaper, right? So what basically this particular webjacking could be? So anyone would be trying to give the meaning? If we can have the discussion, then we can learn in better way. Hijacking means, have you come across with the word hijacking?
So webjacking means taking over some servers or networks.
Taking over some
other servers and some other servers or networks.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So taking over some other network means what it could be? What is that? Will you please try to elaborate? Or anybody else?
So like, for example, in this meeting, you are the host and someone else tries to become host. That is called as
yes,
something similar to webjacking.
Yeah. Very good. Very good example. Yes. So webjacking basically here, it talks about the websites. Okay. So webjack, you might have heard the hijacking, right? Hijacking is will refer to what? Taking control of a aeroplane during the flight. During that time, if someone tries to take the control of entire flight, then that is something called as hijacking, right? The similar way, webjacking means taking control of the entire website. Taking control means what? The entire modification or the control can be illegally gained by someone, and that someone will be definitely a criminal, cyber criminal here. Basically, this webjacking can be done, or the cyber criminals are interested to webjack the web pages or websites which are government websites, or the websites which have financial information in it. So financial information means it could be some websites related to a banking sector, a particular bank's website can be webjacked, means the control can be taken, entire control can be taken by a cyber criminals. What could be the main reason for webjacking? Or what will be the process involved in the webjacking? Basically, in order to do the webjacking, they require the username and the password of the server. As you mentioned, the taking the control over the server. So the websites would be hosted on particular servers. And if the cyber criminal gets to break into the system and gets to know the credentials, that is username and password, in order to get connected to that particular server, once do they that one, then they could be able to take the control and they can try to make a certain changes such a way that the actual owner of the web server will never get a permission to again host into the system. That type can be done, or in some other way, the webjacking can also referred as web spoofing. Okay, email spoofing we had studied. It can be now also called as web spoofing. Means the cyber criminals will try to create a website which looks alike same as the original website. Okay, say for one particular bank or say Facebook, you have a Facebook account, say, then there will be a server for that one, Facebook, www.facebook.com. Okay, now what the criminals will do, they will try to create a website which is same as or which looks similar to the Facebook web page. If that link is given to you, if that link is shared with you, what you would in turn do, if you just click on those particular links, it will open up a web page, and if you don't notice it properly, you may think that this is the original web, Facebook website, and you will go ahead and enter your username and password. But ideally, that particular website is an web-jacked website, or they, the cyber criminals would have created the website, which will be looking same like the original websites. As soon as you enter your details like username and password, those username and password would be redirected to the cyber criminals, and they will be having a mechanism like once, as soon as you enter the login button, you click on login button, it will redirect to the original website saying that there was some problem in getting connected, you log in again. So you will just ignore that message that there could be probably a problem, that's why you did not get logged into. You will again, once again, you will try to log in. So this time when you log in, it will, you may get logged into the original website, but you could have given your credentials, that is username and password, to the cyber criminal. Okay. So nowadays, in the earlier days, webjacking was came in where the cyber criminals used to jack it completely. They used to take the control of the website completely. But nowadays they have become a smarter. Instead of taking the entire control, before taking the entire control, they could try to create a spoofed websites. Okay. And by taking the, making the spoofed websites, they are able to gain the information like user information, username, password, if it is a social networking, or if it is with respect to the banking environment, they would send you a kind of a spoofed messages, emails. Okay. And there could be certain links. If you just click on those particular links, it will open up an web page, which will be looking like a same bank website, and you will end up in entering your details. But ultimately you would be giving your details to the criminals. It is a new way of web checking the websites or the web servers. Is that understood, students? Hello, students. Is that understood? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubts here with respect to webjacking? So here basically webjacking occurs when someone forcefully takes control of a website. The first stage involves password sniffing. Password sniffing means retrieving the password for of a particular web service. Okay. The actual owner of the website will not have any control over what appears on the website. This was the actually the webjacking, but in the current terminologies, webjacking could be the creating the duplicate websites that can also be referred as webjacking. Okay, we'll proceed further to the next cybercrime. The next cybercrime is industrial spying or industrial espionage. We had come across with this particular word, that is espionage. Espionage means spying, a person who spies over the industrial environment. Okay. So basically this industrial espionage means what? Here they would be, the cyber criminals would be spying on the industrial data. They would be interested in retrieving the data such as a particular financial information about a particular product in a company. Or if there is an research and development happening with respect to one particular product, so that information they would be trying to steal it so that they can use it for their purpose, or they could sell it to the third party. Okay. Or anything which is something related to the strategies of a particular business, what type of strategies they are involving in developing a product into the market. So those related information, the espionages will be spying on that, and they would be able to retrieve the data. And this is industrial spying has become very easy nowadays. Anybody can try to gain the information of a particular product. Okay. If a person or an individual having a little bit of information on the internet and certain technologies, they could be able to, it is possible for them to do the spying on not only the industrial, it could be on any of the technologies. How it is achieved basically? Now, the, you know that internet has, it is we can say the internet has certain problems also or disadvantages also. Since we are putting all the information on the internet and making it publicly available, certain people are there who wants to take a disadvantage of this one by providing the information which will help in doing the cyber crimes. If someone wishes to hack something, then information is already available on the internet, or certain type of programs or certain type of Trojan horses or the viruses are available. Using those thing, viruses or the Trojan horses, they could easily hack into others' industry and retrieve the information of that particular business which that particular industry is running. Any doubts, students here? Your voice is breaking up. Am I not audible?
So voice is breaking fully.
Frequently, yeah. Actually, I'm getting a message here that internet is unstable. That is keep on popping up. Let me try to repeat once again. Okay, industrial spying. How about now? Is my voice audible to you?
Yes, sir. Now it's audible.
Okay. So basically, this industrial spying or industrial espionage means the spies who are interested in retrieving the certain information. Okay, like financial information of a particular company or a particular product, or it could be the kind of a research and development R&D which is happening with respect to a development of one particular product, could be a private sector, or it could be a government sector, or it could be certain strategies with respect to the marketing of a particular product. If a Hello, am I audible, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I got again pop-up message, so fine. Say, think that there are two particular companies who are doing this, who are in the same market, who would be producing the similar type of products.